welcome everyone to another show from Forever Paws Animal Shelter, straight from the paws. Today it's just Bev and myself, my co-host. Hi, Bev.
Hi, Gail.
How you doing?
Good. We're having a great day already.
We're having a great time. Yep. Getting all set up with Michelle. It's been a lot of fun so far.
It's been a lot of fun in the studio today.
It has been. So today we're here to talk to you about our upcoming event called the Celebration of Giving. And I'm going to let Bev give you a little bit of the details about it.
So let's say, first of all, the Celebration of Giving is our annual event. It's usually considered our largest fundraiser. We'd like to bring people together, have a dinner, give an award, have the silent auction, and we also sell raffle tickets that event. So it's an all-encompassing event. It's actually three events in one.
Correct. And the cost is?
So this year, we're keeping the cost the same. We're keeping it at $45. And that basically pays for the meal. We don't make a lot of money on the meal.
No, we don't.
So we're trying to keep the cost down. We'll have a buffet for the dinner, and we're trying to change it up this year, thanks to Sherry at White's. Did you notice?
Yeah, it is White's.
So we usually have this event at Rachel's Lakesider in Dartmouth, which is owned by White's. But last year, we were a little on the crowded side. So we did talk to Sherry about it. We moved it over to White's. We will have the lodge room. I think it's called the Cosmopolitan Room. Who knows?
I'm not sure. It doesn't matter.
It's the room we had the trees in last year.
That's right.
So we'll look at it like that. So that's a larger room. The auction will be in that room also this year. So we're at White's. Our date is September 27th. It's the last Friday in September. And it's our doors open at 6:30.
6 o'clock.
Oh, doors open at 6 o'clock. That's why I gave the details.
Yeah, and I want to tell people a little bit about a silent auction. A lot of people that come will say to us, you know, your prices are really great. What we do is we ask for donations, and then we start the bidding at half the cost of what it is, and then it could be increments of 2 or 5, depending on the value. But we try to keep everything at a reasonable cost. So people, a lot of people come in and say, I buy Christmas presents and, you know, and celebration for that. And they say, you know, my holiday gifts. And I'm thinking, that's a great idea. So I try to do it too. But Bev and I are so busy that every time I go back in, which is a minuscule amount of time, I get outbid. So
we try to get the gift certificates.
Yeah.
I love some of the gift certificates. And I say, Gail, go in and get my gift certificate for me. But we usually get outbidded because we can't keep going back inside.
But this year it's going to be in the same room. It's going to be in the peripheral of the room. So we're really excited about that. I think it's going to be a great event. And I want to also share that we also have a PowerPoint presentation put together by one of our volunteers, Angela Lynn, and she does an excellent job. Anyone that attends gets an idea of what the shelter is like in review for the whole year. It's awesome. And then what we also have is there's a president, you see, I am the boss, so they tell me. I don't know how that works sometimes, but I am the boss, and I give a presentation, and I also share with our guests our statistics for the year. I let people
sometimes
know.
I'm blown away by the statistics.
Yeah, I know.
Because that's the only time I hear them, and the numbers are incredible.
They are. They are incredible. As we know, we've got the city of Fall River, the city of New Bedford, and the town of Westport for statistics. And it really is amazing how many animals are in and out of this building. You'll be shocked if you come. You would really be shocked. And I'm inviting the audience to please come and purchase tickets. You can purchase your tickets at 508-678-0804. It is a great, great event, and we're really happy that, you know, with people that come. We have a lot of people that come on a regular basis, but we would love to have more people in our audience join us and see exactly what we do at Forever Paws. Bev, why don't you tell them about this?
So this little booklet here is your traditional sponsor booklet. People donate or actually give us money to put an ad in the booklet. But the booklet's more than that. It's a little bit of stuff that's going on at the shelter. For instance, in this little book, I can show you what our person did. If you look at this little page over here, oops, I forget we're on camera. You'll see all the animals that are at the shelter for a fun day, just little things that are going on at the shelter. You'll see some volunteers in there. You'll see animals that got adopted walking out the building. So this is little extra stuff that we put in, as well as the ads that you can see on the front cover, on the back cover, we have ads. We also have in here the person who is getting an award. I can turn to that page.
No, you don't need to do that.
Oh, yes, I do. I just got to get the page. I should have put a thing in to see
it. It's called the Hearts Humanitarian Award.
And there it is. So our Hearts for Paws Humanitarian Award last year was no other than Gail Furtado. She was nominated by the Board of Directors, and she was given the Hearts for Paws Humanitarian Award. It's an award for outstanding service to the shelter and the animals at the shelter. No better person, believe me, deserves it than she did. So that was an award that was given. We've been giving this award now for 7 years.
I think it's seven years.
We find one person in the community who has done outstanding service to Forever Paws, and then we give them this award. It's a plaque that we put up in the shelter and have your name on it forever.
Yes, it does.
And then it's a trophy type of gift that we give. And as well as your name in the book. So Gail will keep this book forever because it's got her picture and her name in the book.
Yes.
She really fought us for this, but she was outvoted. The board recognized all the work that she does at Forever Paws, for Forever Paws, at the shelter, and all around the shelter. So that's what this book is about. And I have over here a document that shows how you can get an ad in the book and the prices. And we came up with these cute little names. For instance, if you want a cover, that's called a Great Dane. I mean, how appropriate, right? And then if you want an inside page, full page, we call that the Top Cat. We don't let the dogs outwin the cats in the shelter.
True.
And we also have the Tweety Bird, because, you know, you got to have that as an animal too. And then you also had a Friend of Forever Paws. That's only $25. So if you just want to have your name in print, just send $25 to the shelter with this ad, and you'll have your name in print in the book. And the last one, of course, is the Wonder Dog. So there are two dogs, one cat and a bird.
Mm-hmm.
We should have included other animals like hamsters and gerbils.
Yeah, let's not get crazy.
We could have just kept on going.
Yeah, let's not get crazy.
But anyway, this is the form that you would fill out, and it's got your name, your business name, and the price of the ad, and that price is a very reasonable, from $500, $250, $100, $25, and $50. So, and you can get your name in the book and your business in the book. Like right here on the back, we have a business. It's called Dr. Philip Robitaille Dentist. He buys the back cover all the time. And, you know, your name could be there. Your name could be in the book. And this year, we might even have a couple of colored pages. So many people last year wanted the back cover that we're going to create an inside color page.
Yeah,
which
hopefully
will be the
someone
same
else,
thing
right,
if people
exactly.
still continue to.
And on the Friends on Forever Paws, like somebody you can say congratulations to the winner
Correct,
or something
winner.
Like that. You could put a little bit of note
or
if you want.
Thank you for my favorite
right.
dog or
in
cat,
memory of.
Or in memory of.
Yes.
That's the Friends page. For $25, it's a nice way to honor somebody or a pet. So we did create that page especially for that.
Yeah, I will say, and I will proudly say, that a lot of people have said to me when they come to the event and when they have newer, you know, people that haven't been there before, they say, I am amazed as to the statistics. And it's funny because I guess I'm okay as a public speaker because people say to me, I really enjoy listening to what you have to say. And I'm like, really?
Well, she does crack a few jokes
in
there.
I do crack a few jokes. And you know, it was humbling last year. I really did not want that award. I said it should not be a board of director, and I did get voted down. And I got to tell you a really funny story. I ended up doing, again, I love to give to the community, and last year, Bev and I went and worked for the Preservation Society and helped the sign in Fall River that says, Welcome to the Highlands. I ended up, both of us ended, but myself, worse than Bev, ended up with poison sumac. And I was in bad straits, and that day of the event, I was like, I'm not going. And Bev's like, what do you mean? I said, it's crawling up my neck, and I was really in a bad way. So
itchy and pain.
It was very painful, and I was like, this is not going to happen. And she's like, you can't back out now. And I'm like, okay. So I survived that.
Not only that, but she bought a nice outfit.
Yeah, right.
She had to wear the outfit.
Yeah, so I did survive, but let me tell you, it was, so last year, well, my point is that a lot of people were buying me drinks because I was the nominee, and it sort of helped me make it through the evening because it was very difficult. But again, we do share a lot of information about the shelter, and very proud of what goes on.
And I'd like to add that the statistics are not handwritten, like guessing how many dogs
came
in.
No, they're all done.
It's all computer generated. So our program is called Shelter. It's a shelter program software. And it automatically puts the statistics in. So an animal comes in, an animal gets adopted, an animal gets claimed, an animal gets transferred to another facility. All of that is documented through the computer. Right. We don't have to make up these numbers.
No, they're all valid numbers.
So we do
numbers.
This year we do a lot of wildlife because our director is wildlife certified now. And so that counts to us statistics. We have pigeons, we get ferrets, and we get hawks, and we get eagles. I don't know what else we get.
We have a dove right now.
We have a
sick
dove. Yeah. A sick dove at the shelter. So, I mean, these are the things that come into the shelter now that we never used to have. It used to be dogs and cats.
Right.
So that's why this shelter program keeps track of all the species that come into the shelter, as well as where they went.
I want to just add a little something while I'm thinking about it, because, you know, usually I'll forget about it, is we used to collect, and I always proudly say at the meeting, when I give my speech, I say, we're still bottles, we collect bottles and cans. This year, sadly, we had to stop collecting bottles and cans. The family, the husband and wife team that did it have, you know, can no longer do it. And so we had to stop collecting bottles and cans. So if any of you out there have generously donated to us the bottles and cans, sadly, we can no longer accept them. We couldn't find anyone else to do it, and it is time consuming, and it's a very nasty, dirty job because people will drop their dirty, you know, garbage in the crate that we had set up for it, and just very bad things. So we just decided that we had to stop doing that.
We did it for over 20 years.
We did. We've done it for over 20 years, and it was very successful, and unfortunately, we had to stop. So some of you might be wondering why I have this book on the side of me, and I am going to share this information very proudly, and I'm actually going to read to you. I know that some of the other programs that you have on, people read the Herald News and other stories, so I want to just tell you, this is a book by Meg Mitchell Moore. It's called The Islanders, and it's about one summer, three strangers, and an island full of secrets. And the island that we're talking about is Block Island, right in Rhode Island, right next to us. The irony of this is one day I'm going on my front porch and I find this book, and I was quite surprised, and I looked at it and I said, wow, you know, where did this book come from? And it was signed by the author, and it just says that, it's actually was written out to Bev and I, and it says, thank you for all of your work with the animals in Fall River. Hugs and kisses, Meg Moore. And I thought, wow, that's really nice.
Who's Meg Moore, I said.
Yeah, so she asked me, who's Meg Moore? I said, well, it's right there. It's the author, Bev.
But,
and she goes,
but did she know us? I said.
Right. How did this woman find out about us? Why did we get this just left on our porch? Well, ironically, we found out a couple of days later. We were attending a function for the shelter, one of the functions that we were invited to, and we happened to see our neighbor, Jim Soule. And Jim Soule, if you don't know, you probably do, is the Preservation Society president. He happened to be on Block Island, and someone gave him this book, and the author was there, and so he went and got the book, autographed for us, and I said, well, okay, why? And he said, well, look at page 19. So I'm just going to read to you a little bit here. In high school, she had volunteered once a week at the Forever Paws Animal Shelter on Linwood Street in Fall River because a boxer mix she found behind an abandoned warehouse with the tip of one ear was missing. The author had researched the area, and one of the main characters by the name of Joy, she put that she had volunteered at Forever Paws Animal Shelter. So obviously Bev and I were ecstatic when we saw that, and you know, we didn't know, we just thought the book was there, it was a local book, we had to figure it out. But Jim shared that book with us. So I'm telling you, I have read the book. It was a very interesting, I call it a beach read. It's not exactly my genre, but I did very thoroughly enjoy it. And the author has written several books. She's from the area. And, well, she's not, I mean, Mass, I mean, Rhode Island, you know, Newburyport, Mass.
Newburyport, Mass. It's a little hike, but she's, that's
right. And she does have, I did get in touch with her by email. She does have a shelter dog. that she's adopted, and that's why she wanted to add it in. And I asked her if I could purchase another book so that we could have it at our silent auction.
But you wanted it signed.
I did, and she graciously autographed it for me, and so it will be on sale at our fundraiser at the silent auction. So this is why the book is here today, and very excited about it because Meg, you know, was very nice, and we conversed back and forth, and I, you know, did a review for her on Amazon because, like I said, I did enjoy the book. So when it's out there, it is out there on Amazon, and, you know, you can publish, you know, purchase it at local bookstores, which there are not many anymore, but she does have a good, you know, she has, it was a great book, and I highly recommend it. So, talking a little bit more about our event.
Yes, we want to talk a little bit about our silent auction. So, I would like to explain to the audience what the silent auction is for. It's items that are donated or purchased by volunteers, community members, and board of directors. So at our auction, we have an array of items. People have said to us, why don't you put it on the computer first? And I was like, well, I'd love to be able to do that if I knew what we had ahead of time. But our silent auction is given to us by the community, and they sometimes walk into the event with a basket. So we really never know what's coming into our silent auction. And that's all right with us. We do have a lot of items in our auction, and like I said, we do them very reasonably priced. We never have things that cost $1,000, or very rarely do we get anything that's over $100. Mm. So that's one of the reasons, but one of the items that, or the part of the items that we have are gift certificates. I'm going to show pictures up here today, I think, of just the gift certificate table. It is enormous, the amount of gift certificates that we get, and people love gift certificates. I love them.
Right, that's what I was talking about, Christmas
and
presents.
We can't get them.
I know.
We're never fast enough to get them because we're usually too busy. But the gift certificate table is incredible. And we will have, usually gift certificates range from $20 to maybe, I know the Back Eddy is always a $100 mm-hmm. gift certificate. And last year we had a gift certificate for a night in Providence at the Providence Hotel.
Right.
And that was like a $250 or $300 value.
I don't remember the value.
And we started the bidding, you know, at 50% of that price. So people grab these gift certificates like crazy. And they go fast. I have to say, people go right up to that top. I've actually seen people go right to the top bid immediately.
Right, they do.
So you'd have the Back Eddy, instead of playing around with $50, $55, they go right to $100. I just put it down, I want it. And then somebody will fake them out and go, I'll go $110. So they actually go over the price of the gift certificate. So we do have an array of items. And just so you know, we also receive from many of the pet stores in our community, items for our fundraiser. Last year, we had items all the way from Florida, from Port Charlotte, Florida. We had a basket from a store down there. Mm-hmm. We get baskets from stores all over the place, and then we'll get boxes of items from stores like Petco, PetSmart, any of the area pet stores, they'll give us boxes of items that we put together and make baskets. So you will see at our auction loads of pet supplies, and we put them at a very reasonable price because we don't want to take them back to the shelter. And they were all donated by the pet stores, and they don't mind what price we put. I usually take the price of the item, let's say it's a dog jacket and it's $35, so we'll put the bidding at $15 and work our way up from there. So you can get some wonderful dog and cat items at reasonable prices at our auction. It's really a great place to shop.
It is. Next thing we do also is we have our committee, board of directors, and our fundraising committee. They are just also, they're always, you know, donating for the shelter. I mean, it is incredible. And we did have someone this year that gave us a couple hundred dollars. So Bev and I went up to New Hampshire and purchased a lot of wine, like 200 something dollars worth of wine. And so we're going to have hopefully 50 bottles of wine, and you're going to have a number on the bag. And we're going to also have Joyce, who's on our board of directors, Joyce Pincinol. Everybody knows Joyce in Fall River. You go to the Fall River Libraries, children's department, you know Joyce, she and I make chocolate-covered strawberries.
Correct.
And usually if I'm busy this time, she'll do it by herself. And so you get a chocolate-covered strawberry, which, by the way, is very delicious, and you get a number underneath it, and then you get the bag that correlates with the, you know, the strawberry that you just got. And in the bag, you get a bottle of wine, and either a scratch ticket or maybe a gift certificate, maybe for $10. We charge $20 for the bag, so you get your value on sometimes at least and more than that. And more than that. So that's a very interesting thing. People love it. They go right over. That sells out very, very quickly.
Right, and the bottle of wine costs you $20, and you're getting at least $20 back.
Yes, absolutely.
So you're getting something back for, and it's a donation to Forever Paws. So that's another thing that we do. Plus, we sell the white book raffle.
We sell the raffle tickets that night.
That night, too. Yeah. I mean, we put them out in the mail, and people have already been mailing back the book raffle. Mm-hmm. And the grand prize, $1,000. That's nice. That's a nice chunk of change.
It is.
If you're present at the event, I give you $1,000 that night.
Right.
So that's a wonderful thing to put $1,000 in your pocket if you go to the event and you win. So you have the dinner, which will be a buffet. We're not sure what the meal is.
Not yet.
You get the white book raffle. You'll meet our honoree, which I don't know if Gail wants to talk to her about tonight.
No, just.
You'll go into the auction room and purchase items in the auction, and then you can buy a bottle of wine.
Yeah, very quickly, our nominee this year is Tiffany Fredette. It's our administrator's wife. She does a lot of extra things for us. For example, she's the one that created the booklet, you know, the cover of the booklet. She does She does a lot of our graphics for us, designs, and she really enjoys doing it. And she does events with Casey when someone else can't go, and she goes on, you know, they go on a vacation, they take a side trip to go pick up animals. So she's been wonderful, and we're very blessed to have her. So that's why she was nominated this year, and she's sort of like me, did not want to accept it because she's rather shy, but she will be there, and she's accepted it. So just in summary, if you're interested in doing a sponsorship for the booklet, you can contact 508-678-0804, and we will give you the information that you will need. We'll provide that. If you want to donate a silent auction gift, I have a woman that's a painter that she adopted from the shelter. She's sending me a painting. I had somebody from someplace in Rhode Island, Wakefield, Rhode Island, sent us a whole box of jewelry and things. Please contact that same number, and we'll be more than happy to get you involved. And last, of course, but not least, please purchase tickets. We have a bigger room this year. We have the space available. So I'd like to go over our numbers and make sure that we have a lot of people there to be at the silent auction to, you know, purchase things and also possibly win that raffle. So that is what we've got about the celebration of giving. And lastly, we want to share with you another event that's going to be coming up in October.
So this is a fun word. It's called Pawtoberfest. Tiffany created the word. Tiffany also created this flyer that we're using. So Pawtoberfest is your traditional Oktoberfest. This year we're holding it at Troy City Brewery in Fall River. It's Wednesday, October 16th, and it's going to be held 6 to 10 o'clock, and dogs will be welcomed on the outside patio.
The outside.
And you're going to get a sampling of all the craft beers that are down there. I believe the tickets are
$25.
And you're also going to get food from a food truck called Avos Feast.
Yep.
So that's also going to be a part of it, and there will be music. So this event should be a lot of fun. It's an indoor-outdoor event.
Weather permitting.
It's a come-and-go event. You don't have to sit there and stay and listen to people talk. You can sit there, listen to the music, enjoy the beer.
Lady's name, Lacey Cheryl.
Oh, well, that's right. Who's?
I think it's Lacey. Is it Lacey? Yeah, it's Lacey Cheryl.
Who is that? Is that the music person?
Lacey Cheryl, that's the music person, and she's donating her time, which we really appreciate.
Oh, wow, that's wonderful. I didn't even realize that.
She is.
So this is a brand new event for us, for Forever Paws. We have had Oktoberfest in the past, so this one is going to be brand new down at Troy City Brewery. Down, I think it's on near Anawan Street,
mm-hmm.
and
yep.
in that area where the battleship is down there. So please call 508-678-0804 if you would like to purchase tickets for the Oktoberfest, which is called Pawtoberfest.
Yes, I'm having a hard time saying that.
Pawtoberfest, that's it. For $25, and enjoy yourself for a night out. And before we close, I wanted to explain to some people about Casey Fredette's blog. Do you remember the blog?
Yes, I do.
So Casey Fredette's our director, administrator at Forever Paws, and he came up with a blog on our website, and the blog explained how animal shelters are so different today than they were years ago. Years ago, animal shelters were all about cats and dogs and adoptions and probably euthanasia. Today, we're different at animal shelters because of an influx of what the shelter calls pocket pets.
Yeah.
An animal shelter is built with cages and kennels for dogs and cats, but pocket pets are ferrets and birds and snakes and hamsters and mice and rats, and we are getting an influx of pocket pets at Forever Paws. And our staff was really not hired to deal with these animals.
Not at all.
They don't know how to handle rats. They don't know how to handle parakeets and parrots and finch, snakes, turtle. We've had turtles. We've had any number of rats and mice that come into the shelter. And it's really caused, a different experience for our staff to be able to learn how to handle these kind of animals. And believe it or not, these animals are getting adopted. People are coming in and they're saying, oh, I hear you have hamsters, I hear you have mice, I hear you have rats. And so these animals are getting adopted. And I just wanted to put out there in the audience that if you're interested in looking for one of these pocket pets, you should read the blog on foreverpaws.com that Casey has put up regarding the influx of pocket pets. Believe it or not, we actually had a fish tank.
Yes, donated.
A donated fish tank. And believe me, it wasn't an empty tank.
No.
It was filled with water and plants and fish.
Yeah.
And it got adopted. It's weird.
Yeah, it is. What happened was, again, and it's sad, but an elderly man had loved his fish and so on, and he could no longer take care of it.
Right.
And it was, you know, he just couldn't do it. And I guess he was going into assisted living or something. And
right.
He was very, very concerned about it. And he called up, and Casey said, sure, you know.
We'll take it.
We'll take it. And we did. And believe it or not, about a week later, he found someone to take it, and we had to transport.
A fish tank.
The fish tank with the animal, you know, with the fish were on the side.
Yep.
Well, not in it, but they were, weren't they bagged or something? I don't know.
I don't know how he did it.
Yeah, but
it did go.
Yeah,
you know.
It is amazing what people will donate to the shelter, and people get upset. And, you know, the other thing, too, one very quick closing I'd like to mention. People get upset and they kind of, you know, get upset on Facebook because they say, well, I didn't get the animal of my choice and they pick someone else and I was the best person. And we all think we would be the best home for the animals. And we get that. Sometimes the decisions are very difficult to make and, you know, and sometimes the choices are very easy. When we say the animal's not good with kids, if you have kids, we're not going to adopt it to you, no matter how well you say, how well behaved your child is. It's just the way it is. So, folks, understand that we, as a shelter, do the best that we can for the animal and for the people we're adopting to. We want to make it the forever home. We don't want you in 3 months to say, this isn't working out. You got to take this dog back. You got to take this cat, ferret, whatever it may be, back because it's not working for our family. That's how we work it out. It's sometimes it is just, you know, it's not a toss of the coin. It's not a first come, first serve. It's really trying to match the family and match the animal, whatever the animal may be, with the correct family. So people get upset. People kind of bash us on Facebook and get very upset about it. But I stand by our word that we do the best that we can. I want to thank everyone today. I hope you learned a lot about Forever Paws. Hope that you'll be interested in contacting us. And, you know, 508-678-0804. And join us at our celebration of giving.
And if you want, don't forget, the Pawtoberfest is around the corner.
Thank you.